The question is, why is there confusion in the mind? What's your name?
Sukhdeep.
Good, Sukhdeep. What is confusion?
Duvidha.
What is confusion?
Dwanda.
Confusion is conflict. Confusion is the presence of many options and your inability to know. Confused. There are so many things and they are tangled together, they are fused together. That is what confusion is. We said the brain is nothing but external influences. And remember, it is not one external influence that enslaves the brain. The brain is a slave to a thousand masters. Brain is a highly fragmented entity. Fragmented. And each fragment is ruled by a different influence. So there is one part of your brain which is ruled by family, papa and mummy. One by friends, one by media, one by teachers, one by religion, one by ideologies, one by corporations, and so on and so forth. So your brain is a battleground where all these influences are fighting with each other. It's like a man who is being pulled in 100 different directions by 100 different influences. Now do you see what confusion is? Where to go? Which way to go? The tragedy is, whichever way you go will not be your own way. There are 10 people pulling me in 10 different directions. Even if one of them succeeds in taking me in one direction, still it is not my direction. It is an external direction. In confusion, you have 10 options, 10 choices in your mind, right? That's what happens. The funny part is, not a single of those choices, not even one of those choices, is really your choice.
What is our choice?
You have to find that out. You have to find that out.
What is the definition of that?
Your choice can be presently only described in the negativa, which is that your choice is that which is not anybody else's choice. So first find out how much of my life is dominated by others. That's the first step. You cannot start by directly asking what is my choice, because you are already full of choices. Others' choices.
So we are depending on others' choices because we think we ourselves are incapable of making our own choice.
You don't even think of that. The moment you see that, freedom is begun. The moment you see that, freedom has already begun. We don't even see that. We are caught in an illusion that those choices that have been given by others to us are actually our choices. The one who starts seeing that these are not my choices, for him, the process of freedom has already begun in some sense. Are you getting it? Faintly, it has already begun. So first of all, you look at your life and see that whatever you do throughout the day, what aims, aspirations, ambitions you have for your life, how much of that is driven by external masters, influences of the media, the society, and the rest of it, family, education, religion, everything, tradition, convention, general trends, how much of that is driven by all that? You will always remain confused till the time you are not proceeding with your own intelligence. And let me drop a hint. Whenever you see options, know that you are a slave. If you always have lots of options in front of you, then it's slavery. The intelligent man never has any options. He just knows the right thing. Just knows. He does not wonder that out of these five options which one to choose. He just knows the right. He is never confused. He knows. Are you getting it? If you are someone who always has options and is in fact looking for more and more options, then that means that you are just intelligence man is choiceless. He sees only one road, which is his road, and he knows that this is it. He does not have any botheration about the rest of it.
Sir, how he knows?
Is this intuition?
No, it is not intuition. It is just knowing, direct realization. Just knowing. When you say how he knows, you are asking for some kind of a method of knowing. There is no real method of knowing. This knowing is a complete contact. This knowing in that sense is being. You see, when you have external knowledge, there is difference between you and the knowledge, right? There is you who is getting the knowledge and there is knowledge that is coming to you. For the intelligent man, there is no separation between him and the knowledge, there is a complete contact. He is the knowing. He is the knowing. It is his nature to know. He just knows. And we are not talking of information here. We are not talking of knowledge here. We are talking of something else. Knowledge and information will always come from outside. From encyclopedias, from Google, from the rest of the places. We are not talking of that. We are talking of the movement of life. He knows that fully well. He does not have to depend on anybody else. He has no choices. No choices at all. If you are confused, it might just be a good step to reject all the choices. If four choices make you confused, it might be a good step to just reject all four of them. Because had they been really your thing, any single one of them, had they been really your thing, you could not have been confused. Get rid of all of them. They are not that. They are not your thing.